Hello. In this learning dialogue, we are going to give focus on why and what about the WordPress dashboard, WordPress posts, pages, and at the end we will also see difference between WordPress posts and pages. To begin with, let us gain knowledge about the WordPress dashboard. The dashboard that is WP Admin is the first screen you see when you log into the administration area of your blog. You can get to dashboard by adding /WP-admin to the end of your site's URL. In dashboard area, you can catch up on news, view your drought posts, see who is linking to you or how popular your content's been. Basically, it is like a bird's eye view of operations, from which you can swoop down into the particular details. Next thing that we are going to see is the WordPress posts. A WordPress post is what makes up the blog aspect of your site. These are generally news or informational updates about a certain topic or talking point. Posts are listed in reverse chronological order and can be tagged, categorized, and even archived on your site. You can think of an example of posts at the news portion in your site. They are dynamic and constantly changing the content your end users sees. Let us see some insights about the WordPress pages. WordPress pages are similar to posts in that they have a title and body text. Pages are generally reserved for static content or information. Examples of this would be an About Us or Contact Us page in a typical site. Pages are not listed by date and cannot be categorized or tagged like WordPress posts. Pages can have a hierarchy, which means you can nest pages under other pages by making one the parent of the other, thus creating a group of pages. Now, we have gained knowledge about WordPress posts and pages, so it's a time to differentiate between them. Posts are timely content part of a series of posts in a blog, whereas pages are the static one-off type of documents which are not tied to the blog's reverse chronological order of content. Next difference is, pages can be hierarchical, which means a page can have sub-pages. For example, a parent page titled About Us can have a sub-page called Our Vision. On the other hand, posts are not hierarchical. By default, posts in WordPress can be sorted into taxonomies, categories, and tags. Pages do not have categories or tags. One way to differ is with respect to utilization. Pages can utilize custom page templates. Posts cannot utilize this feature by default in WordPress. And the last one, WordPress posts are displayed in RSS feeds, while pages are excluded from feeds. To summarize, in this learning dialogue we have seen basic content types in WordPress. In the upcoming learning dialogues, we will see how we can deal with WordPress posts and pages by adding or editing them. Thank you.